Long ago, oh, not so far away, I fell in love with you. Before a second show, your guitar, it sang so sweet. But you're not really here. It's just a radio. Don't you remember you told me you loved me, baby? Said you'd be coming back this weekend, baby. Baby, 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 oh baby. Well, hi there, Pluckers. I've a sore fingers again. Oh, put my teeth back in. I've a sore fingers again with you for hopefully another interesting lesson. A classic song from the Carpenters, of course, called Superstar, written by Leon Russell, I believe. Okay. Standard tuning, but I do have a capo on the first fret. This puts us into the same key as the Carpenters records. Okay. By all means, if you want to take, you know, don't bother with the capo, just play without the capo and just use the same chord sequences, etc., that I'm about to show you. You'll be fine. Okay, so let's get to it. So, starts off the intro with an E minor ninth. So it's an E minor with little pinky added to the second fret of the top E string. Okay, and a nice sort of a slow strum downwards. Okay. Then take the pinky off and play the top E string open, and then the second string open. So, then another quick strum on the E minor, just a straightforward E minor. And then take your fingers away and play the fourth string to the top E string open. Okay, so you've got. Just the fourth, that's just an open E minor seventh from the fourth string to the top E string, open strings. Then add a finger. I'm going to use my second finger on the top E string again on the second fret. So four down to one again. Then the top E string open. So then put that back on the second fret. Again, play the four strings if you want, or single notes, up to you. Do that, or whichever you fancy the sound of. Okay, so far. Okay, then what I do is I put my third finger on that third fret from the capo on the top E string, and my first finger going to the first fret of the second string. Okay, four down to one again, and then go down to the second fret on the top E string with your second finger. So, right, then play a straightforward C chord, emphasizing that top E string open. Okay, so now you've got this. Then what we do is we play the top E string, a little pause after the C, a little pause, and then play the top E string open. Then put your pinky on that third fret of the second string. And then play like an E minor seventh. That's just the second fret of the fifth string. I'm using my second finger. Second fret of the fifth string from the capo and then 5 down to 1. Well, the 4th string, 3rd string, 2nd string and top E string are all open. 2nd fret of the 5th string there. E minor 7, okay? So now we've got this. Okay, then we can play an A7. That's an A chord with an open 3rd string, 2nd on the 4th and 2nd on the 2nd, 5 down to 1 again. So now we've got this. Sorry, I've muffled that note. Start again, sorry. After that E minor 7th, little pause, and then another very slight, very quick, another quick one before the A7 if you like. Okay, so we just go through it again, so we get up to that point. Then we have a little run, 2nd on the 4th from the capo, 4th on the 4th from the capo, open 3rd, so a more simple one there. Then we play a D chord, 4 down to 1, 4 down to 1, okay, and then another partial C chord with a D in the bass, so just a single finger on the 1st fret of the 2nd string. 4th string open, 3rd string open, top E string open, just 2nd string on the 1st fret, 4 down to 1 again, so you've got D, and then this partial C chord with A in the bass, D in the bass rather, then keeping that 1st finger where it is, make up like an A minor 7, 2nd on the 4th string with the 2nd finger, and play 4 down to 1 again, so now you've got D, partial C with D in the bass, A minor 7th, and finally I'm playing a partial B minor, so playing a B minor chord like that, simple diagonal chord, 2nd on the 1st, 3rd on the 2nd, and 4th fret of the 3rd, open 4th string, 4 down to 1 again. So you've got all, each one of these chords is just 4 down to 1, okay, so 4, D, C with D in the bass, A minor 7th, D, B minor with D in the bass, and then E minor. And then we can do a sort of backward rake near the bridge somewhere, an upward arpeggiate sort of thing. And a couple more strums and we're into the verse. Okay, so let's just go through that again. This is probably the hardest part of the song, to be honest. Okay, so here we go. And then the verse kicks in, and it's E minor, long ago. Then we make an E minor 7th by just removing your 3rd finger, opening up the 4th string, just keeping that 2nd finger on that 2nd on the 5th. So E minor to E minor 7, okay? Long ago, E minor 7th. Again, if you want, you can go 4 down to 1, so you're emphasising that D open string. Da da, da da C da, da, da. Then that E minor 7th again, just a single finger on that 2nd fret of the 5th string, 5 down to 1 da, da. So long ago and oh so far away, I fell in A7 again, with you, C chord before the And then we have a B minor. You can play a simple B minor or a bar chord B minor, second fret. Now this is a bit of a bone of contention, the next bit, but we'll just go through the verse again. Long ago, oh, so far away, I fell in love with you before the second show. Now, you could just play the B minor there, and go back and start the next verse on E minor. But I think there's a very quick B major in that before it goes back to the E minor. Okay, so it's subtle, but it's there. But it's hidden by the orchestration, I think. So it's coming out of that. Let's go for the first verse again. I think what you do need to do is stop. Second show. Bit of a pause and then single B chord. Just before you go back to the E minor. Now you could play a quick B7, I suppose. But I think it's a B natural, okay? So you could play a simple B minor, a simple one like that. Second fret from the cap on the top E string. Then the fourth fret of the fourth, third, and second strings like that. Or you can play it as a bar chord, either three fingers like that, or a bar with your third finger. Yeah. So I think it's there. I think that's what's going on that record. But you know, you could just leave it as the B minor, but it's up to you. Okay. So coming out, do we just go through that again? Long ago, and oh so far. I fell in love before the second show. Oh, same again, same sort of sequence. C to B minor seventh, but yeah, A7, C, B minor is a radio. Quick B, again, quick, very quick B, just before this time you go into the chorus, and the chorus is C, don't you remember, B minor, told me, A minor, G, baby, repeat, C, said you come in, B minor, A minor, G, again, baby, C, B minor, baby, A minor, baby, oh, G, baby. F, love you. And then a C major 7. Okay, C major 7 is a C chord with just the first finger left off, open second string, 5 down to 1. Okay, and obviously an F, you know, you can play a simple F, 4 fingered F, a bar chord F, whichever F you fancy. Okay, and there you have it. That's basically all that's in the song. Okay. It goes into another verse, obviously, and it comes out of what does it do that? Now I think actually it comes out of that, it goes into the intro again. I think you play the intro again, then it does another verse, and then another chorus, and then the only thing that's different is right at the end of the song, it does two choruses at the end of the song before it finishes, okay? So you come into that last couple of choruses after you've done the third or second verse, whichever way you want to call it, C. Don't you remember you told me about your baby? Said you'd be coming back this weekend, baby. Baby, 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 oh baby, oh baby. I love you. Instead of going to the C major 7, you go to a G chord, okay? So it goes, that last one is baby, 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 oh baby, I love you, G, I really do, goes back in another chorus. And again, said you'd be coming back this weekend, but it'll be less time. Baby, 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 F. I love you. C major 7th. I really do. And it plays a B minor to finish on. Okay? So that's the way the song finishes. Okay? So you do two choruses at the end, and instead of going to the C major 7th, where it goes after the F, love you, you go to a G. I really do. Build up again. C, and then there's another chorus. Three times. Again. Baby, baby, baby. F. I love you. C major 7th. I really do. Finishes on the B minor. So there you have it. Okay, so we'll just quickly go through. Is there anything, adapting? Is there anything else in it, really? No, there's nothing really in it. So that's it, basically. Everything, I've shown you everything that's in the song. So mix and match, okay? Enjoy. Thanks a lot for watching and listening, and I'll see you in the next lesson. Bye for now.